Considering keyboard-only users, at a glance. Hi, I'm Guy Barker. I'm here to tell you about how to support a keyboard-only experience on the web and in apps. Keyboard-only users rely on using the keyboard to be efficient. They're often the stars of the movies. The hotshot hacker is at the keyboard with only 30 seconds to complete the mission, with hands whizzing over the keyboard, never once reaching for the mouse or touching the screen. Success is realized with only 1 second to spare, and we can breathe again. In most applications, keyboard users will press the Tab key to move focus to a control. For example, on the New Document page of Microsoft Word, pressing the Tab key moves focus from the Search for Online Templates field to the Search button, to the suggested searches, and then to the blank document item. Now, using the left and right arrow keys, I can navigate between the different templates that are displayed. This is more efficient for me than having every single document template be a tab stop. I can use the Tab key to move from one group of items to the next, and then use the arrow keys to navigate the individual items within each group. Also, as I move keyboard focus around, it is clearly displayed visually. When an item that is almost off-screen receives focus, it automatically scrolls into view. Interactive controls need to receive keyboard focus, and they must display the focus visually. Interactive controls need a well-thought-out keyboard model. For example, in Microsoft Word, there are many interactive elements. If a keyboard user had to tab through every single one, it could take a long time to navigate the UI. That's why Word enables users to bypass groups of controls. Keyboard shortcuts for an application should always be documented. In Word, the keyboard shortcuts can be found through the Help menu. Thanks for watching. To learn more, visit microsoft.com/accessibility.